Today I want to talk about my new planted tank build. If you've been following me on Instagram and or Facebook live video, live from the garage, working on a tank build as we speak, you already know the details and or at least a little bit about this aquarium. With that said, the tank is now built and I want to go over a little bit of the details before we get any further. The tank is made out of acrylic. It's a 3/4 inch cell cast acrylic and or 19 millimeter. You might be wondering why so thick. Well, it's going to be a braceless and or rimless tank. This tank actually happened by chance though. If you remember the 375 gallon tank build, you'll remember that it is also made out of 3/4 inch cell cast acrylic or 19 millimeter. Now look at the lids though. You see, when I created this tank, I cut out sections out of the top of the tank to create areas for lids and or access panels. I didn't let that acrylic go to waste though. I took that acrylic and cut it to size, cleaned it up, and built a tank out of it. Obviously, I needed a little bit more acrylic, so I used other pieces of offcuts from that original tank build. You see, when building an acrylic aquarium, you buy the sheets by the full sheet typically. And every once in a while, you'll have a little bit of acrylic left over. And I always try to repurpose it and or use it for something. That is, of course, if I'm not maximizing the entire sheets and building full aquariums out of them. Now, when it comes to big, thick acrylic like this, they don't typically function well as lids. So after cutting out the holes for that 375 gallon tank, repurposing the acrylic, and building this tank out of them, I actually built other lids that make far more sense for that tank, which you'll see eventually. So a couple of details on the tank I know you're curious about. The tank is 20 inches long, it is 20 inches wide, and it is 18 inches tall. Now these are pretty curious dimensions, but they were planned specifically around a few things. The first thing is I'm building it specifically to fit in this space. It will fit perfectly here, and I'm also gonna build the stand to match the 375 gallon stand. The second thing was I already know the aquascape that I want to keep, as well as the aquatic life I want to house inside of it. So the tank and dimensions are built and designed around specifically what I want to do with it. However, the tank actually started out, or at least the acrylic panel started out, being 2 feet by 2 feet. So originally I was going to build a cube tank. Now just because that tank would have been bigger and wider, it's not what I needed or wanted. And that's the beauty about building your own aquariums, is you can literally get out of it exactly what you want. And that is the end result here. You see, if I did go by the 24 by 24 inch dimensions, one, it would not have fit in the location that I want to keep it. Two, I would have had to brace it, and I wouldn't have been able to get this braceless look. Finally, three, it would have actually been more difficult to light. So while I still get the look of a cube tank here, I find that it's actually more functional than a 2x2x2 tank. Okay, a couple more details on the tank before we move any further. We know the tank is 20 inches long, 20 inches wide, and 18 inches tall. It holds about 30 gallons of water. The look I was going for is to create a completely seamless aquarium so that the focus is on the inhabitants and the aquascape that I'm going to create, as opposed to any sort of trim, bracing, or anything else that could distract from it. One thing to note though is that I actually went with rounded corners, and that was inspired by the drop-off tank that I had yet to set up. However, I've become infatuated with the fact of how sleek this looks with the rounded corners. And with acrylic, it's really easy to do. Since we're here, I might as well give you an update on the drop-off tank. Obviously, it's not set up yet, but that time will come. More on that near the end of this video. I will be doing a full step-by-step tutorial on how to build these tanks in the near future. On that note, obviously, I have other builds on the go as well. Like the 375 gallon tank build series that starts this Sunday. Once that tank build series has completely aired, I'll then start the planted tank series, followed by the drop-off tank. But let's not forget about all the offcuts that we had from the 375 gallon tank build. We still have to figure out something to build with that. So like I said, plans for the planted tank, I already know exactly what I want to do. I already have a vision for the hardscape as well as the plants I want to keep, not to mention the livestock that's going in it. Knowing all of that, I already know what I'm going to use for all of the materials. But I wanted to ask you guys, if this was your tank, what would you do with it? Let me know what you would do for the hardscape, stocking, and plants. Also include what you would use for lights, if you would go CO2, high tech, low tech. Just give me a general idea of what you would do if this was your tank and leave those in the comment section below. Now, given that this tank is going in my office, the next thing I'm going to have to do is build a stand for it. Now that stand is going to match my 375 gallon stand identically, which I'm really excited about because this is an awesome stand, which I will of course be showing you how to build in the 375 gallon tank series. Now, if you haven't been following along with the updates of what's going on with this tank, obviously it's completely done. However, we still need to address what's going in the tank. Originally, I thought I was going to do a massive tank of Trophius, which are African cichlids. I've decided instead to take my Asian arowana, move him to this tank, and instead of putting Trophius in this tank, I'm going to put him in this tank. Speaking of the Asian arowana, he's doing great. In fact, he's pretty excited to be getting some tank mates for this tank, and those tank mates actually arrive tonight. If you're not actually familiar with this guy, I have done tank mates in this aquarium in the past. The thing is that he tries to kill everything he's in there with. I've also done some plants, driftwood, and so forth, and he destroys all of it. With that said, though, I'm hoping that when I move him, the move will be such a culture shock to him that he will adjust to the new tank mates that are already established in that tank. But I don't know, we're just gonna have to see. Let's just hope I pick the right tank mates for him. So obviously I have a tremendous amount of build on the go, and they're all kind of happening around the same time. So I guess the point of today's video was simply to remind you that while I do have the big 375 gallon tank build series starting up this Sunday, and I do know that that tank build series might not apply to other people, and or you might never do it, or you might not have any interest in it, I simply wanted to show you that there are a lot of cool smaller builds coming. These builds simply take time though, so please bear with me as I will have everything out eventually. I also know that many of you watching right now are not subscribed to this channel, so make sure you subscribe or you're gonna miss out on all of this.